Searching for a school for your kids, especially in a new country like Portugal, can be really stressful. So in this video, I'll be walking you through key considerations that you should have when thinking about this decision, but as well giving you resources on how to search for public and also for private schools. So let's talk about schools and location, because the family might have a location in their mind and you also might have a school in your mind or educational system in your mind. So let's start if you're going for a location. If you've chosen a location that you're in love with in Portugal, this is something you need to consider, which is you might not have all the basic education and secondary system education in the same location. So what might happen? Maybe your kid goes locally to the basic education, but you might have to bus him to another city to finish his secondary education. So those are considerations that you need to have when you're very passionate about a location and you say, this is the dream place I want to be. You really need to understand what is the school system that exists around, especially the public one. And the second one is for if you're going private international schools. Here you have many locations that have international schools. So you can see what are your top locations in which you see a blend of my favorite education system for my kids and the location that I can live with. So if you've chosen your dream location and you're set on that, I'm going to be doing a demo of a fantastic resource, which is a website that has the ranking of all the public and private schools by location. So I'll be showing you how to search for your location and see what are the schools that exist there and where they stand on the ranking. So either you're reviewing your locations and confirming if the schools are top ranked, or are you just double checking that your loving location, if you've chosen, doesn't have horrible schools? This is a way to get that cleared out. Looking at this awesome resource that's called the Ranking the Escolas. This was made by the magazine called Público, and it was launched in 2020 and is looking back at the school year of 2019. And this resource is amazing because it allows you to research by the area you're thinking to live and check out what are the schools that are available and how they rank against the other ones in the country. You can look at the ones from the 9th grade, and you can also look at secundario, so you should be double checking in the area that you've chosen that there is schools for both of them, so you don't need to send your kids, bus him to another secundario. Okay, so let's get looking here at the specifics. You can be searching here by filtering by public and private schools. You can filter it by the region, the city, and even go a little bit in more depth to specific areas. And you can also filter by the disciplines. This is for the 9th grade, and also for the secundario, you can also look at all of them. First one I want to talk about is called Contextos. I will not be using it for this filtering in the search, but I wanted to bring it to your attention so you know what it means. So Contexto 1 means the place where the parents of the kid have average less school years, they've studied less years. Contexto 2 is in between, and Contexto 3 means it's the parents of the kids that had more school years, meaning that they even went to university. So that's what it means, the contextos. Another good thing of this page is that you can actually search for the specific school. So if you know the name of the schools in the areas you want to be living, go here, you type it, and you can get immediately that information. As well, this little green wheel represents the public school, and these couple of pink wheels is the private school. So a couple more things to pay attention here is now we are looking at the 9th grade, and the grades that the kids get on the 9th grade is from 1 to 5. And on the secundario, the grades they get is from 0 to 20. And on the secundario, which is the 12th grade, I want to bring to your attention the fact that don't take to letter the average that you see here, because you need to think about that this is the last year of school and some kids simply are not going to pursue university, so therefore they put very little effort on their grades. They just want to pass. And when they do this, they basically bring down the average of the school. So there might be kids that have fantastic grades, like 18 average, 19. But if the rest of the class is like, I'm not going to go to university and I just want to pass, they're going to pull down that average. So take that into consideration. And if there's a school you like and you see that the average is a little bit lower on secundario, I would advise you to reach out to school, get a better understanding of what's going on there, or also go onto Facebook and try to find groups of parents that have kids in that school or alumni, so you can clear that up for you. If you're getting value out of this video, don't forget to hit that like button, because it's free for you and makes a huge difference to our family channel. Thank you. And we're gonna start in Lisbon, because there's a considerable number of schools there. Okay, so let's hit here on the map Lisbon. And you can immediately spot here that the majority of the schools that are popping here on the rank are private. And here is the reason why, because the kids that are in these private schools, they are committed to get into university. So therefore, they put a lot of effort on those grades so they can get into the universities they want to join. But let's take a look here. Let's hit filter and also take a look at the public schools. And you can see there is several public schools that are as well very well positioned. Now I'm looking at Lisbon, the district, but let's look at Lisbon, the city center. And clicking here, you can see a lot of these schools are pretty well positioned and they are really in the center of the city. Like the first one is in the great Bairro of Estrela, and the other ones are in Restelo. So very well located as well. The region of Setúbal. And let me look at all schools. And interesting enough, the first school that you see here on the top, it's private, but is also an international school. So this school, St. Peter's School, it has a British curriculum from Cambridge, and also it has an international baccalaureate certification. So that's great to see here on the top of the list. But let's also look at what's going on with the public ones. And you see there is several options of public schools as well that are decently positioned as well in the ranking. Look here at one of the expat favorite regions, which is the Silver Coast, and I'm gonna be looking at Coimbra. So here in Coimbra, you can see something pretty great is that, okay, you have two top schools that are private, but look at the next ones. They are all public schools. So it's a region that definitely has a lot of really good public schools. When you click on the schools, you can actually get a little bit more information. So let's look at here at this public one, Secundaria Infanta Dona Maria. And here you can see where it stands on the ranking. You can see the average grade. And you also see here what I was mentioning before about the context, which is how many years of school have the parents had. So you can see here for the dads and for the moms, how many years of school they have. Interesting information, if you scroll down this page, is you can actually see the average grades for all the key subjects that you test on the 12th grade. So that's great information to see. And you also see how they rank on each one of these subjects across the country. So lots of great information. So here you have it. This is an awesome resource that gives you the opportunity to search by the region in which you want to live. You can see if there's a 9th grade school, if there's also secundario in the area you're interested. You can deep dive on the best schools, private and public. You can look at the grades. So lots of great information to help you trim down that search to find that school for your family. Regarding the international schools, there is several across the country. I'm right now compiling a list with all the schools that exist in Portugal. So down below, there's my mailing list, subscribe to it. And once I'm finished with this list, I'll be sending it out to everyone that subscribe. And I'll be calling out in that list all the international schools from the country, but also giving you an insight of what is the price range for the ones that have it publicly, and as well, what are the grades and what are the degrees certifications that you come out from those schools. But something that I realized is there is no single one resource where you can look at all the international schools. I found several websites, but none that gives you everything from the center to the north to the south of Portugal. So what I did is I started compiling a list with all the schools, with their accreditations, what's their curriculum, and all the essential information for you to make a decision which schools you want to contact and get more information on. And I'm compiling that information on Google Docs. I'm almost finishing. And if you're interested in getting this list, you subscribe to the channel and also subscribe to my newsletter, because that's where I'll be sending it out once I finish. So I've been collecting information regarding where is the school located, but as well key information regarding what is the primary language, what are the accreditations they have, what's the curriculum they have, and a very important one, what is the price range. So here you have it, a lot of information to help you trim down that search and contact only the schools that you're really interested in. So public and private, you haven't decided, you're still pondering which one of them is the best solution for my family. So here are some questions you should be asking yourself. The first one is pretty easy. Do you want to pay for it or you don't want to pay for it? If you don't want to spend additional money, then public is definitely the choice for you. The second question is, how old is your kid? Maybe he's younger, like our kids are young, they're toddlers, and they speak English, they don't speak any Portuguese. So we thought when we go to Portugal, we'll just go public because they are young and they can catch up the language pretty quick. But now if you think about the older kids that might have a challenge of moving to the country on top of all so much change, maybe you want to find him a more, let's say, comfortable environment with people that speak the same language as him. So maybe there it's a consideration to go towards an international school where he will have colleagues that speak as well English. But keep in mind that more and more in Portugal, there's public schools that are also starting to be bilingual. So that's always something you should be checking out and doing your own research to finding those schools as well. Another consideration is, is it better to bite the bullet and maybe your kid struggles a little bit, but then he's completely inserted into the culture, into the language, and making local friends? That's another consideration to have. I mean, everyone says that kids are truly sponges, so maybe there's an opportunity there. Maybe if your kid, I don't know, it's 9 and 10th, he might just jump right into it. Why not? That's something that you need to think about as a family, if it makes sense for your family to go on that challenge. So choosing a school for your kids, for your family, is a big decision, and it can be really stressful because it's a big change for the family, for the kids. So hopefully all these considerations help you and equip you to make your choice, because there's no right or wrong choice. Every kid is different, every family has different needs. Hopefully all these resources I've provided you on how to search for the public and the private can help you get to that decision. We are a family of four moving to Portugal, and education is a huge topic for a family. We have two small kids that will be entering the school system, so we'll be doing a lot of research about it. So let us know down below, what are your comments? What are your other questions? Thank you.